गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिल्की त्रिपाठी। डियर चिल्ड्रेन, वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 8, दैट इज द टॉपिक इज सम कंपैरेटिव केस स्टडीज। दिस चैप्टर विल इनेबल अस टू नो मच मोर अबाउट द कंपैरेटिव केस स्टडीज। सो let's start now this topic. Textile industry is among the oldest industries known to the humankind. Iron and steel industry too has been in existence in different forms for thousands of years. Unlike these two, the information technology industry is not quite old, but it stands out as the most rapidly growing industry in the world. Through comparative studies of these three industries, we can understand where India stands on the road to industrial development. Through some case studies, we shall learn how Indian industry has developed in relation to industries in Japan and the US. So, now we shall compare about the industrial growth and development of our country as compared to the other countries. The iron and steel industry. The Tata Iron and Steel Company, located in Jamshedpur, that is in Jharkhand. The Tata Iron and Steel Company, TISCO, is one of the oldest steel plant in the country. It is a private sector enterprise. The company came into existence in 1907. Its location at Sanchi in the Singhbhum district of Jharkhand. तब ये जो है बिहार का एक पार्ट हुआ करता था, अब झारखंड। इट हैज बिकम ए सेपरेट स्टेट नाउ। फर्स्ट टाइम द टिस्को, दिस इज द ओल्डेस्ट स्टील प्लांट इन द कंट्री दैट बिलोंग्स टू द प्राइवेट सेक्टर। And in 1907, it came to the existence. After Sir Jamshedji Tata, who pioneered the economic development of Sanchi, this town has been renamed Jamshedpur. Jamshedji Tata, who was the founder of Tata Iron and Steel Plant, who established the economic development of Sanchi, and after him it was renamed as Jamshedpur. Some of the major factors that must have encouraged Jamshedji Tata to set up the iron and steel plant here are described ahead. Now we shall watch the Jamshedji Tata's steel plant here. Jamshedpur has an ideal location in terms of transport network. It is 240 kilometers from Kolkata and lies on the major harbour of Nagpur-Mumbai rail line. It is also well connected by road to most part of the country. This makes it easy to bring in raw materials and dispatch finished steel products quickly and economically. The port in Kolkata, 240
facilitates exports. Raw materials required for the plant are found within a small radius in the Chota Nagpur Plateau, iron ore from Mayurbhanj and Kendurzhagar in Odisha, and Singhbhum in Jharkhand, coking coal from Raniganj and Jharia coal fields in West Bengal, limestone from Garhpur in Odisha, and manganese from Kendurzhagar. TISCO owns and operates most of its mines. TISCO has its own coal-fired thermal plants and thermoelectric plants. Besides the Damodar Valley Corporation, a multi-purpose project also supplies hydroelectric power to the plant. The iron and steel industry is labor-intensive. Due to their dense population, the neighboring states of West Bengal and Odisha can provide all the labor required. Both the local and the British government supported Jamshedji venture in obtaining land with the promise of a guaranteed market for the products. The Chota Nagpur Plateau region is a major industrial region where steel products have a high demand for the manufacture of masonry, tools, automobiles, locomotives and other goods. The Subarnarekha and Kharkhai rivers in the region ensure regular supply of water required by the plant. The TISCO plant has undergone remarkable changes over the years, marked by its expansion and modernization. Its blast furnaces, steel coke ovens, converters and rolling mills produce pig iron, steel of various types of steel rods, billets, bars and sheets. Detroit, the auto capital of the world. Detroit is located between Lake Huron and Lake Erie in Michigan state. USA, nicknamed automobile capital of the world, it is also one of the major steel making centers in the US. Integrated steel plants involved in all stages of steel production are located here, owing to the number of favorable conditions. Detroit is the operational base for several automobile giants: Ford, Chrysler and General Motors. Here the assembly line method of production is adopted. Raw materials required for steel production are available in close proximity. Iron ore comes from the Mesabi range on the shores of Lake Superior. Coal is brought in by ore cars and wagons from the north and middle Appalachian coal fields. Limestone is quarried from the nearby islands in Lake Erie or from the western shore of Lake Huron. A dedicated land is available for the development of large steel plants. The Great Lakes and St. Lawrence Seaway serve as an excellent means of water transport for raw materials and finished steel products. A dense network of road and railroads aids to easy and cheap movement of raw materials and steel products to industrial market. Access to the Atlantic ports is also a major advantage for exports and imports. Detroit gets regular supply of hydroelectric power from the Niagara Falls power plants. Skilled labor is available locally and from the neighboring regions, which are the most populated parts of the country. However, unlike in Jamshedpur, this labor does not come cheap, and so labor cost is a major component in the total production cost. Detroit has the advantage of a huge market for steel products in nearby industrial centers and in the local automobile, engineering, defense equipment and spare parts and component industry. Exports to European and West Asian markets are also convenient via the Great Lake, St. Lawrence Seaway. The Detroit steel and automobile industry has undergone rapid growth due to the huge demand for motor vehicles in the Midwest. The US, where railways are not the best alternative, it does have some problems, very high cost of production and competition from Asia.